Hi, I'm Dr. Ray Drury with the Upper Cervical Spine Center, and today I'd like to talk to you about how Meniere's disease and the inner ear type of symptoms can not only be started from a whiplash type of injury, but if it can also be aggravated. So what happens is the message from the ear travels to the brain via a nerve called the vestibular cochlear nerve. Vestibular part is your balance, cochlear part is your hearing. Most of the time with Meniere's disease, patients will go to an ENT or a medical doctor and they'll check the inner ear, or they'll check their ear out and they say, hey, there's nothing wrong with your ear. But somehow or another, the symptoms you have are ear-related, right? It's balance, it's hearing, it's ringing in the ears. So if the message from the ear going to the brain travels through that nerve, if that nerve gets interfered with, then the message that leaves the ear, the normal message traveling down the nerve, can be changed before it gets to the brain, so the brain senses something other than what the ear is trying to send it. There's one place that can happen. That's the top of the neck, the brainstem area. And that is where the nerve actually goes into the nerve system, right at the top of the neck. So what happens is a lot of times people come to us with Meniere's disease, and we can relate it back to some sort of trauma, some sort of fall, accident, or whiplash, okay? Whiplash seems to be the most common, where either you're stopped and your head keeps going, or your head stopped and your body keeps going. A lot of times after some sort of a car wreck, some sort of an accident, can create that whiplash movement. Then we have this big, heavy head, weighs 10 to 12 pounds. Well, it sits on a bone that weighs about 3 ounces. So you can imagine how easy it is to have that big bowling ball bounce back and across that tiny little bone. So if that happens, that puts pressure at the brainstem. And what it'll do is it'll interfere with the message from the body to the brain, in this case, the inner ear, which can create the vestibular cochlear symptoms, the balance, the hearing, the ringing in the ear symptoms. So if you've ever been in an accident, if you have Meniere's disease or symptoms related to Meniere's disease, then there's a good chance that that accident is what initially created it. If you have had Meniere's before, for a while or whatever, and then there was an accident somewhere midterm, that can actually make it worse. Okay, so if you have Meniere's disease, regardless whether you can put your finger on a specific whiplash or accident that could have started it, find an upper cervical doctor near you. If you live in the Charlotte area, Lake Norman, Lake Wylie, Pineville Matthews, Belmont, Gastonia, Rock Hill, Fort Mill, we're the doctor for you. Give our office a call, 704-588-5560. We'll get you in as soon as we can. We'll do a full upper cervical evaluation to determine if you have an upper cervical problem that could be causing your Meniere's. If so, we're going to explain to you what we need to do to fix it. If not, we're going to find someone else that can. We'll find another specialist that can help you, okay? If you know live in Charlotte area, Google it. Try to find an upper cervical doc near you. Let's get to the root cause of your Meniere's. Let's get this thing squashed once and for all. I wish you the best of luck. Hopefully one day we'll get a chance to meet. I'm Dr. Ray Drury. We'll meet you soon. Have a great day.